Hello everyone, myself Mr. Shivappa M. Metagar. I am working as assistant professor in computer science and engineering department at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. I welcome to the session on network hardware. The last video we have discussed about the uses of computer network. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to describe the concept of computer network hardware and the concept of PAN, LAN, WAN and MAN. Okay. Agenda: about network hardware, personal area network, local area network, metropolitan area network, wide area network. These are the points I am going to cover in this video. About network hardware: broadcast links and the point-to-point links. Broadcast link broadcast simultaneous transmission of the same message to multiple recipient. It is a broadcast. If one user want to transmit the data to simultaneously more than two users, then that time they can use the concept of broadcast. Okay. Point to point, connect individual pairs of machines. It means one to one communication, we have to use the point to point concept. Okay. Unicasting, transmission with exactly one sender and one receiver is an unicasting. Multicasting, single sender and multiple receivers on a network. For example, in one LAN connection, only one server is there, multiple LAN, clients are connected to that LAN server. It means all the clients can get the data from the single server. That is multicasting. That is single sender and multiple receivers on a network. How many systems are get connected to that particular server, all the connected devices can get the information from the single server. That is multicasting. About network hardware: so interprocessor distances, processor located in same. Okay, these are examples. Okay, 1 meter, that is a square meter, that is an the example is in PAN, that is personal area network. The distance is in 10 meter, the processor is in room, it can be used in a room, and then 100 meter building, 1 kilometer campus. These three can be used in a local area network. That one, 10 kilometer can be used in a city, that is metropolitan area network. Okay, 10 kilometer, so 100 kilometer country, and then 1000 kilometer continent, it can be used in wide area network. Okay, 10,000 kilometer planet, then continent, we have to use, that is internet. This is a classification of interconnected processors by scale. First one is personal area network. This PAN devices communicate over the range of person. If here in the PAN devices, limited area we have to use, and then limited distances we have to cover by using the PAN. The Bluetooth to connect these component without wires. If the PAN connected devices is there in one places, then it can covers that limited area. Then that limited, if any one person can come to that area, there is no need to use any cables, then automatically it will get connected to that particular devices. Devices Bluetooth, it means then when there is no need to cables, automatically it will get connected if that person is entered in that particular area. That is PAN. Okay, PAN can also built in RFID on smart cards and library books to get the information. Okay, so PAN area, this is example Bluetooth PAN configuration. This is a one device. These are another devices, that is a monitor, keyboard, mouse, keyboard and CPU. These devices can be connected to this monitor if all the devices are there in a particular range, if whatever the range it may be. Okay, local area network, the group of computers connected within a building, within a campus or in a home, that we can call it as a local area network. It can covers the one home or city, home or building or office. Okay, LANs have a higher data rate as compared to WAN, that is 100 Mbps to 40 Gbps. We have to compare, that is WAN. Okay, LAN do not have involves lease lines, cabling and equipment belong to the LAN owner. Corresponding to lower two layers of OSI reference OSI model, but mostly LAN do not follow OSI model. That is here this is a wireless and this is a wire. In a wireless, the access point is there. These are the devices get connected to this access point without using any cables. These are laptops. It is get connected to this access point. If some other devices want to connect through wire, it means they can use this device that is the part that is two wired network. Okay. Here is Ethernet switch is there. This Ethernet switch can contain different ports, and then if you, how many ports are there, that many devices can be connected by using some cable. That cable is an Ethernet cable. If these are the ports get connected to that particular respective devices, if the user want to get connect some other devices, it means they have kept this port for remaining, that is to rest of network. This is wireless and wired LANs. Ethernet, that is IEEE 802.3, it is an most common type of wired LAN. It can be used in a LAN to give the connection. Okay, some sample topology for of switched Ethernet is an IEEE standard. It is also possible to divide one large physical LAN into two smaller logical LANs. Okay, both wireless and wired broadcast network can be divided into static and dynamic designs. Metropolitan area network, this MAN covers city. For example, if the user want to distribute the television network, then that time they can use the concept of MAN, that is a cable television network. Okay, high speed network has been standardized as 802.16 and is then popularly known as WiMAX. A MAN uses distributed queue dual bus and range within 100 km in a city, that is MAN. Okay, this is a simple example. One diagram is there. This antenna, this user want to distribute television network to all the users are there in a city. These are the different offices or home. It is there in a single city. These offices or homes are get connected to that head office. This one is get connected to the antenna. This antenna can distribute the data to all the devices. This antenna can cover the city. Okay, that is the metropolitan area network on cable TV. Okay, next, this is a question answer section. Think and write. It can contain one question. What are the advantages and disadvantages of MAN? Now pause the video and answer the above question. The answer for the above question is advantages. It provides a good backbone for a large network and provides greater access to WANs. The dual bus used in MAN helps the transmission of data in both directions simultaneously. Okay, a MAN usually encompasses several blocks of a city or an entire city. Disadvantages are more cable required for MAN connection from one place to another place. Okay, it is difficult to make the system secure from the hacker. These are the advantages and disadvantages of MAN. Okay, industrial equipment or graphical reasons also. Okay, WAN, it provides a longer distances transmission of data like voice, image, video, audio. If users want to transmit this data, in that time it can use the WAN concept. Okay, information over a large geographical area, its range is beyond 100 km. Okay, this is a sample diagram. The satellite communication is there, a cellular connection is there, and then here international offices are there, and then mobile employees there, and then some other places are there. By using wide area network concept, all these devices can get the information. That information may be the voice, image, video, audio, whatever it may be. They can get the information without using any wired connection. Okay, that is wide area network. Okay, difference between LAN, MAN, WAN. Okay, expands the local area network, metropolitan area network, wide area network, range is in communication network, links a number of stations, local area range is 1 to 10 km, here is 100 km, and then range is beyond 100 km. Okay, media, use guided media, here in guided media as well as unguided. Here we have to use unguided media. Then speed is in high speed, that is the 100 kbps to 100 mbps. Then optimized for a large geographical area than LAN, long distance communication. Okay, cost, LAN is in cheaper, it's a man is in costly and then expensive. Equipment, NIC, switch and hub we have to use, and then in a man we have to use modem and router, and then WAN we have to use microwave, radio, infrared laser. Okay, these are the references I use for preparing the above PPT. Thank you.